हेलो एवरीवन, इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स. व्हाट इज पॉलिटिक्स, हाउ इट वर्क्स. सो दीज ऑल काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वी गोना कवर. व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. व्हाट इज पॉलिटिक्स? इट इज बेसिकली वेरी लो लेवल ऑफ क्वेश्चन, बट इट कैन बी आस्क इन द इंटरव्यू. व्हाट इज पॉलिटिक्स एंड फॉर व्हाट पर्पज वी हैव यूज्ड. There is no standard answer for it, but what we can say that it is a driving data analytics tool that would help to retrieve any volume of the data by developing the workflows. So it is very simple and we can do it in a very automated way. There can be many answer of it. It can be a predictive analytics tool. It can be a split analysis tool. And this might be the case that an interviewer might ask you, what are the various scenarios that you encountered while working with Alteryx. We want to cover these scenarios at the end of this topic. So why do you use the Alteryx tool? Because it is very easy to deploy. It is very easy to develop the workflows in that, and it gives us very quick results. So why not we are using the different tools in the market like Informatica and Talent? There are many ETL tools. Why the Alteryx is superior to all of those tools? First reason is it is very easily learnable. The UI of Alteryx is very good and you can relate to your SQL a lot. Let's suppose the input tool tell you that you will take the inputs from SQL or the flat file. The second thing is output tool. The name suggests that it will write. The join tool, it suggests that it will join. But in the other tools, the tool are not that straightforward. In some languages, it might be Rome. Inside some languages, it might be anything else. The second reason why we are using this, because it does the spatial analysis. No other tool in the market performs the spatial analysis like Alteryx does right now. It will help you find the possible location where you can deliver your goods at. Let's suppose I'm sitting at my home right now. By using the split analysis feature, we can find how many points are in our proximity of 100 kilometers. So this much of capabilities we have in Alteryx. The third thing is, it is no code tool. Like you don't have to write any code in Alteryx. In other tool, it might happen that you have to write the small scripts. Like if you talk about Nine, if you talk about Talent, we write some or a little bit of script in this, but in Alteryx we do not use this. So this might be the answer of your question. The third question is, what is Alteryx server? See, this question is asked a lot in the interviews because most of the people have worked in code design. Like what I will be teaching you is most of the things will be pertaining to the code design of. But there is a limitation in designer. You cannot schedule, you cannot version control, you cannot share the workflow. So all these three features that I take name of, the sharing part, the collaboration part, the scheduling part, and the version control part, all of these take place in Alteryx server. And apart from all of this, everything takes place in Alteryx designer. And the Alteryx server is hosted on a web location, on a web server. It is not locally available to us. So if someone asks you, is it Alteryx server local to the workstation? No, it is not local to the workstation. Now let us move to the other question. The interviewer might ask you, explain some of the most important feature of Alteryx. I'm talking about Alteryx input tools. The input and output. We can access data from any location, any possible location. It may be SharePoint, it may be a local system, it might be cloud, it might be web splitting kind of data. The second thing is, you can similarly write the output to any kind of location. So this is pertaining to only the input tools. And as and when we will move to the other question, I'll explain you the different features of Alteryx. So the question might be asked that what are the different file formats that are being supported in Alteryx? So let us open Alteryx and have a look at what all different data sources we have in Alteryx. It might take a minute to start up the AllQuick, so let us wait till then. So AllQuick is started. Let's have a look at input tools. So let us drag the input tool over here and go to these options. So the major files that are supported is, the first one is Alteryx database file, the YXDB format. In this, you can store data in the AllQuick suitable way of interpreting it. The first thing is that. The second major file is CSV file, the comma separated file. You can interpret. The third file is ClickSense file or ClickView file. Let's suppose you are using the reporting tool that is ClickView in your AllQuick. So you have exported a table using ClickView. You can use QVX file to interpret data. You can use a JSON file. So most of the web data comes through the JSON file. So you can web scrape the data using that file. The fifth file will be obviously the Microsoft Excel file. We can input Microsoft Excel or the Excel binary file. We can even import the macro enabled file. The fifth file will be the Tableau Hyper Data Extract file. So Tableau generates a hyper file, like the data is being used in a hyper format. So we can use that file also. The zip file, obviously, we can use. We can use any other file, .txt file, .log file. If we are having any log data and we want to analyze where we are lying somewhere, so we can use that. Guys, one more thing I want to explain you over here is AllQuick Gallery. We have not added any gallery. So what is AllQuick Gallery? AllQuick Gallery is your organization platform where you will host your data, where you will host your workflow. So let's suppose I click on add a gallery option. What it will do? It will ask the URL of your gallery. Right now, we don't have any URL. We don't have any AllQuick server in our system, but let me try to connect the common AllQuick Gallery. So guys, we'll go to AllQuick Gallery and add a gallery. So have a look at this. HTTPS gallery dot AllQuick.com. So it is the common gallery of AllQuick. Anyone can access it. While you create your account in AllQuick, it will by default give you access of AllQuick gallery. So I have deliberately typed this. A connection to this server has already been added. So while you install AllQuick, you get connection to this gallery by default, where you can check this. Just close this file. You can open workflow and you can go to add AllQuick gallery. So here AllQuick is trying to make a connection to this. It will pop up. It will first ask your credentials. So just enter your credentials, whatever credentials you have used to create account on AllQuick. I will keep myself logged in and connect. It might take a couple of seconds to get me logged in. So we have logged into AllQuick Gallery. Now have a look at this. So AllQuick Gallery is a common platform where a lot of AllQuick users just host their workflow. Let's suppose we talk about Aaron Hartzell. So what he has done, he has added an analytical app and a creative macro. The location is public gallery. If we talk about the file converter today, it is an app that converts file from one format to another. So this is the AllQuick Gallery, and here you will find app, the workflow, the data set, anything you want to find. So if you want to have a look at workflows only, just go to workflow. If you want to have a look at macros, you can go to macro section. This macro and app section, I'll explain you what are the macro and apps, but just a high level overview. Macros are a reusable kind of tool, the reusable kind of stuff in AllQuick, and app is the analytical app that has a user interface. It will prompt for the prompt user for the inputs and you can enter it. So this is AllQuick Gallery. Now This is all location. By default, Alteryx give you a private studio. So 1 year ago, I created a workflow writing of data to the database. I have added that to my private studio, so we can access data from there also. The public gallery is basically the all location plus your private studio. See guys, your private studio, as the name suggests, is private to you. No one else can access your private studio, even if you are using the gallery option, the public gallery of Alteryx. And there might be the case that users have shared a workflow with you. Right now I don't have any, but might be the case the user have shared workflow with you. So this is all about Alteryx gallery. I'll cancel this. I explain you about the files. What are the different type of database that is being supported in Alteryx? And have you connected to any database ever in Alteryx? So this question encountered a lot of time in the interviews, because they want to check whether you have connected to a database or not, or you have just connected to the flat files. So you can just go back to my SQL Server videos and give them explanation that we have connected to SQL Server. And how we connect to a SQL Server is they just create a quick connection, maybe ODBC, and OLEDB is a new type of data source that is being used nowadays. The JDBC has been disconnected or discontinued. And talking about the different databases that we can connect to Adobe Analytics, we can connect to Redshift, we can connect to MongoDB, the SharePoint, and any database you name, it is there. Or even if there are no options to connect to a database, no specific name option, what you can do, you can use a generic ODBC and OLEDB connection. Let's suppose I talk about, I will take any fancy name, the Clickstream data source. The Clickstream is a click tool. We want to connect to that data. That is the ODBC connection. So we can use the generic ODBC connection in that case. So you can have a look at this in detail. So let us move to a different question. Is there any limit on the number of rows and column retrieved from Alteryx? We are talking about the databases over here, not the flat files. So is there any limitation that you can retrieve this much of rows and this much of columns only?
While there are no limitation on the number of rows retrieved in Alteryx, but there is a catch. You can only read the data up to 2 GB in a single cell. What I mean to say, in a column, you can read up to only 2 GB of data. And if you talk about the columns, there are load limitation on the number of column. You can read any number of column in Alteryx. So moving to the next question, can you write the table in a database using Alteryx? If yes, which tool will you use and what will be the configuration of it? So the answer to this question is pretty straightforward. Yes, first we can write the data in the database. The second, we will use the output tool. And the third is we will use the output to our database. And what will be the configuration of our tool? Depending upon the table. If you have table existing, you can use the create new append to the table. If you don't have the table, you can create a new table depending upon the usage. That I will cover in the next question. So which CRUD operation in a database you can perform in Alteryx? So guys, CRUD operation in SQL is create, read, update, and delete. Can you perform all of this operation in Alteryx? Yeah, we can perform all of these operations in Alteryx. Read operation, I told you that it can be done using the input tool option. The second thing is the read. No, sorry, create. Yeah, you can create. I just explained in the previous question, you can create a new table. View is update. I'll show you update option. So let's suppose output data and see guys, I'm practically explaining you because I want you to be properly trained in Alteryx and there should be no doubt whatsoever. So remember, we have created a SQL Server 2 connection in our videos. So we will go over here a little faster. You will test on connection. It is successfully tested, and then we will go and okay. Okay, so here is the C operation, the create operation. Now the update operation. The update operation is update, warn of the update for failure, warn error on update failure. Okay, and append existing. So these are the update operations. Delete, yeah, we can delete also. Delete data and append, override table drop. So this option will drop a table and then create it again. So yep, we can create all of the CRUD operations. Now moving to the next question, can you do the web scraping of data in Alpix? Yeah, definitely you can do the web scraping of data in Alpix. You can use any of the JSON file and you can connect to any of the website and then scrape the data. How will you read the files present in a directory in Alpix? So guys, I told you that you can read the file present in the directory in Alpix. You can search subdirectory. And you can also do this using the directory tool. It will retrieve all of the file paths pertaining to a directory, and then using the input tool, you can take the directory name and read the files from there. I will leave up to you to explore this kind of stuff, and you will find a solution on Alpix gadget. If you're stuck somewhere, just let me know. So the next question is, what is the configuration pane? The configuration pane. So I guess I explained it quite well. Let me take this topic again. Yeah, the configuration pane tells you all about the configuration of a tool and the configuration of your workflow. The second thing is, yeah, configuration pane. The configuration pane is different for our tool and different for the workflow. Why it is different? Because there might be certain thing that you want to implement all over the workflow, like annotations. I want to show annotations for all of the tools, not just a single tool. You want to have the runtime errors. If there are any errors encountered, do you want to show them in a workflow or not? You can trigger many of the events from here. And there might be configuration specific to a tool. So this is quite important question, and we'll move to the next question. What will you do if your data start at row number 30 in Excel? Okay, what I'm trying to ask over here, or the interviewer is trying to ask over here, is we'll connect to a sample SQL file. Unable to read this file. Okay, cancel this and let me open on the same file. Okay. Files. I will go to ABC sales, just any random file. What if your data is start at the row number 30? So what if your data start at row number 30? Just simple thing. Start data input at row number 30. What is the difference between the unique tool and the filter tool? So basically, this question is answered to confuse you guys between the usage of these two tools. As the name suggests, the filter tool will just filter out the records depending upon any condition. So you can perform filtering on the integer field, string field, boolean field, or any field, and you have to give a condition. But what is the usage of the unique tool? In the case of unique tool, you will be given an input, and you can have the records.
in case of unique tool, you will be getting the two different stream from the input from the output slots. So unique tool will consider, let's suppose there are 100 records, so and the 20 records are duplicating, so it will be returning the 20 records from the U output of the field and from the D output of the tool, and 80 records from the U output of a tool. So let me show you practically, just an overview. I'll search for the unique tool. It's taking a couple of seconds to search for the tool because there is just hold on for a second. The unique tool is present at the very end, and you can see there are two outputs, U and D, U for unique records and D for duplicate record. It will be taking input from any file. Let us move to different questions. Can formula tool work on the multiple stream of data? What I mean by multiple stream of data, can formula tool take inputs from five or six different files? Let us have a formula tool dragged in our sheet, and we want to connect the multiple inputs from the formula tool. Nope, we cannot select a criteria that is dependent upon the multiple field to formula to filter. So we can only just take the input from a single tool. Now moving to the next question. What is multiple field binning tool? So there are three different type of multi tools. The multi field tool, the multi row tool, and the multi field binning tool. So I am asking what is multi field binning tool. As the name suggests, it will bin the data. It will create the slots of the data depending upon any condition. And it can create the slots or the batches of data depending upon the multiple fields. As the name suggests, multiple field binning. So let's suppose we have a data and we want to create the multiple field binning. So we can create bin on the basis of, this data is not having the numeric fields. So let's suppose we have numeric fields in our data, and we can create the field depending upon the multiple numeric field of data. The other question might be asked from you, that can we create the bins depending upon the string data? So the answer to this question is a strict no. We can only consider the numeric field while considering the binning. The next question, what is the difference in select sample and random sample tool? So basically these three different type of tool are mostly used to select the data. They are not just performing any operation. They are not performing the filtering. They are not performing the formulas. They are just help you reducing the data. Okay. So let us go to the first tool, the select tool. The work of select tool is first to rename the field. Second, to reduce the number of column that would be injected in our workflow. And the third thing is to give the description. So all three you can see here. Select, we'll go to select. And you can see it will show error because this is the first operation. I told you that we can typecast. We can change the type of our column. Secondly, we can change the size of our column. The third thing is we can rename our column. And the fourth thing is we can describe our column. The fifth thing is we can shortlist our column that we need to select. Okay. These are five different type of operation that can be performed using a select tool. Now coming upon the second tool, which is sample tool. So sample tool there is only one work of the sample tool to reduce the data. It cannot change your data type. It cannot reduce the size. It will just filter out the tools. Okay, filter out the records. So let us have a look at this. The sample tool will just filter out record the first n rows and then n rows, skip first n rows. Many different operation are there. The third thing is the random sample. Now everything in the sample tool was fixed as in first n rows, last n rows, skip first n rows, one in every n rows. So we were giving the criteria to filter out our data, to sample our data, but in the random sample tool we do not have any criteria. It is just total random selection of the tool, random n records and random n percent of records. So these three tools are similar yet altogether different. The one operation these all three tool can perform, it will reduce our data. Okay. So let us move to our different set of question now. Is there any way you can change the data type and size of a column? Yeah, I just explained you in the previous scenario only. We can reduce the data size and the data type we can change by using the select tool only. We can use the select tool to do this operation. Can you tell me the practical scenarios of using the multiple row formula? Yeah, let me give you a scenario. This is scenario based question, multi row formula. It's a scenario based tool. I will give you a scenario. Can you generate the ranks using the normal formula? No, we cannot generate the rank, because for generating a rank, we need to refer the other rows to. We need to measure the relativity. So we can perform the rank operation using the multiple row formula tool. Second tool is can you create the running total without using the summarize tool? Yeah, we can create the running total without using the summarize tool. We can sort the records, we can group the records first, and then we can use the multiple row formula to create the running sum.
Can we update the existing sales with the last 3 months running average of sales? So let's suppose we have the data of sales in the city-wise sales for each and every month. Can we replace the existing sales with the 3 months of running average? So the question will be this much only. You have to remember in mind that yeah, we can do it using the multiple row formula. Now the interviewer might ask you, how you gonna refer back to the last 3 months? Okay, so there is one option. You can refer back to the num rows. Using num rows, you can refer back to any number of rows. The second thing is, have a look at this. Can you update our existing sales? You have to update the existing sales. You can create a new column also, but you don't have to create in this scenario. You just want to update the existing sales with the last 3 month running average of sales. So yeah, the answer is multi-row formula. I want to select the number of records from 100 to 1000. Can you tell me the three different ways of doing it? First, by combination of record ID and filter tool. The second is using the limit options in input with import data at line. The third option is, can you tell me what will be the third option? Just a hint, it is in the preparation tools only. So guys, the third option is the select records tool. Okay, you can select any number of numeric ranges of records to return. So I want to select the row number 100 2000. Okay, sorry, we don't want to include 100. We want to include 101 till 1000. Control R, and you can have a look at this. There are 900 record displayed. So the first option is this.
The second option is, obviously, I explained you the record ID tool. And in parallel with this filter tool, you can select the record ID greater than 100 and record ID less than 1001. Control R. So I show you the two different ways. You can see that 900 records are returned from this tool. 900 records are returned from here. And the third different way is, the first one is record ID and the filter. The second one is select records. And the third one is, the third option is to use the limit option, but there is a catch. You cannot use the limit option with any other type of file other than the flat file. You use a flat file over here, transaction.slsx. You can select a random range from here, okay? And you can limit your input. The record limit is 900 and record limit is 1000. Control R. We got the top 1000 record, and then in parallel with this, we will skip first 100 records, and you will get the 900 records now. We have to connect this tool with this thing. And now execute. Now you will get 900 records. So which tool is not the part of preparation tool? I guess it's quite straightforward, but you will get to know this while you are working at least 4 or 5 months in Alteryx. Let's suppose sample tool is there, join tool is there, unique tool is there, and formula tool is there. See, all these are tools in Alteryx, but you should remember what are the part of preparation tools. The preparation tools are only the sample tool, unique tool, and the formula tool. The join tool is the part of join operations. Okay. What is are the choices in select record tool configured? Now, let us go to the select record tool. We will go to the select record tool. What are the options? They are none of the options. I just made it deliberately that you guys will get a little confused between the select record and the sample. If I change it to sample, now you will feel this question is pretty straightforward. Okay. Now I'll make it to sample. Now you have all of the options. First end rows, last end rows, skip first end rows, one in every end row. Have a look at this. Skip first end rows, first n percent of rows, select a range. No, we don't have select a range option in here. We have select a range option in the select record tool, but not in the sample tool. Okay. Is grouping possible in the tile tool? Yep. The grouping is possible in the tile tool. We will go here. And how grouping is possible in tile tool? See, you might get confused in this, that tiling tool is itself a grouping tool. So why would there be an option in the tile tool to group? But it might happen that you have a category A, B, and C. Within that category, you have subcategories. So you want to create the tiles within a category, like three tiles in category A, three tiles in category B, three tiles in categories. So that's why the grouping option is being given in the
tile 2.
Which multi tools are available in Alteryx?
Multi tool is which we can perform operation on multiple rows, multiple column, multiple field, multiple criteria, something like this. So we have multiple sample tool. No, we do not have multiple sample tool. We cannot create multiple sample at once. We will create one sample at one time. For that, we have sample tool and sample record tool. We cannot create multiple sample. Yes, you can create using the create samples, but they are different. They are not just one output. You cannot do something like this from an input tool. You cannot do like 1 to 10, 100 to 200, and 300 to 500 records. You can just give one criteria. Okay. The multiple field binning tool. Yeah, we have multi field binning tool. The multi-row formula, I explained a lot of time. Multi-data type formula, there is nothing like multi-data type formula. Which of these tools have multiple outstream in Alteryx preparation tool? Let us have a look at this. See, this question is very difficult. You have to remember each and every tool to figure out what are the multiple output tool option. The unique tool. Yeah, we have multiple output stream. We have U stream, we have D stream. U give the unique record, D give the duplicate record. In filter tool, yes. We set a condition, we get the true stream and we get the false stream. So yeah, multiple stream in both A and B. Create sample, yeah. In create sample tool, we have three different samples, E, V, and H. Evaluation sample, validation sample, and H is holdout sample. Correct answer for this is D, all of the above. Which tools can change data type or alter existing column in Alteryx? Again, this is a good question. Which tool can change data type or have a look at this question, or alter existing column in Alteryx? So select tool. Can you use select tool to alter the data type or to alter the column? Yeah, we can use select tool. The multi-row formula tool. Yeah, we can use to alter the existing columns. I'll show you how. The multiple row formula tool. There is an option that comes over here, update the existing field. So yeah, you can alter the existing field. Third option is unique tool. We cannot change the data type or we cannot alter the existing column in the unique tool. And filter all tool, is there any tool of filter all type? No, there is no tool of filter all. So the answer to this question is A comma B. The select record tool. Okay, let us have a look at this. Please have a look at the description of this tool. Select specific records and or ranges of record, including discontinuous ranges, useful for troubleshooting and sampling. So control R and let us just limit the number of records to 100. Okay. We want to have a look at the row 5 to row 10, row 20 to row 40, and rows 80 onwards. Okay. Now let us execute this. Parse error, add character 1, parse error. Okay. Now let us have a look at this. Okay. So when I executed this in the starting, make sure guys you are typing the correct ranges. Okay. There are no white space or no space in between. Control R. This might happen that your workflow might fail if there are spaces between them. So 5 to 10, you can have a look at this. 5 to 10, we are having 5 records here. We are having 20 records here, 20 and 5, 25 and 80 plus. So 19 record here, 44 record should be there. Now let us execute this workflow. You can have a look at this 43. How 43 is coming? Because it is just taking the one row from this output. It is not taking the range. Okay. So while we give the range, make sure there are no spaces. No spaces. So it gives you 5 to 10, the inclusive range. So the row number is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are six records returned from this. 20 to 40, we are returning the 21 records, 21 plus 6, 27. And 80 plus, we are returning the 20 records from there. Okay. 81 to 100, we are returning the 20 records. So the total number of records sum up to 48. And you can have a look at this. It is showing the 48 records. What is the difference between the join and join multiple? So as the name suggests, the join tool will join only the two tables and the join multiple tool will join the multiple tables. The first basic difference is this. Let us load the configuration of join tool and the join multiple tool. It's lagging somewhere. Just so in the case of join tool, you can see that we can only join the two tables, but there are three different outputs, L, J, and R. But while we are taking the join multiple tool, we can join the multiple table also, but we are having the single output. Okay, let me show you. Here you can join any number of tables. Okay. But what is the difference between the join and join multiple tool is you cannot do the L part and the R part from the join multiple tool. Okay. You cannot get the matching record, non-matching record from the left input. You cannot get the non-matching record from the R input. Okay. This is the difference between these two tools. Now, how can you create the full join in Alteryx? See, this is a tricky question. It is very much asked in the interviews. How can you create the full join in Alteryx? So full join means you will have record from the left input. You will have record from the right input. And you will have the record, matching record from both of the inputs, L and R inputs. So what is the way to create the full join, to simulate the full join in Alteryx? So the way to simulate full join is, let me tell you, I'll open the example. In the join tool, you can simulate the full join by unioning the L, J, and R outputs. So why I'm saying that the full join will be there? In the J output, you will get the matching records from both. In L output, you will get the remaining record from the left input. In R output, you will get the remaining record from the right input. So L, J, R unionized together will create a full outer join. What is the usage of make group tool and the fuzzy match? So basically these tools are used in the combination of one another, and the make group tool is used to identify the dependencies. Like if A is dependent on B, B is dependent on C, then A is dependent on C. It is used to find the relationship between the rows in the data. Okay. That is the use of make group tool. Now, fuzzy match tool, after creating the relationship from the make group tool, you will identify the duplicates in the tool. Have a look at the explanation of fuzzy match. Identify non-identical duplicates in the data stream. So these three are almost similar and there are some difference of characters in the spelling. Okay. Let's suppose one row is I am. The second is I am. So what is happening essentially? These three records are almost similar to each other, and they will match to an extent of 90% with each other. So we'll set up a threshold criteria, and we will find the non-identical duplicates in our data using the fuzzy match tool. How many tables can you join, and can you perform a join between an Excel and the database? See, this is the tricky question. The interviewer is trying to ask you about the cross database joins. So let me open the window for you, and we will try to create this so that you will be having a fair idea of whether we can create the join between our database and our Excel file. Now I created a input file, and I will import it in Alteryx. Samples, the data, the one tool data. Let us take the consumer file one. Okay, customer file one. It is a YXDB file. Have a look at this, Control R. And now in this input, we will take input from the SQL Server database that we have created previously. What we will do, we will connect to the data sources. We'll connect to Microsoft SQL Server. Quick connect. I'll test the connection first, then it will be able to load the schemas in. I'll not be loading the MSDB. I will load the bike database. Let us take any of the input tables from our database. The reason why I'm taking any of the input tables is just we want to test whether we'll be able to cross database join or not. We do not want to join anything as specific. I go to the DBU, and I just drag the bike output table inside the Visual Query Editor, and I click okay. Now just drag the join tool. See, I know the answer. I could definitely tell you that whether we'll be able to join or not. We will join by record position. Okay, first record will be joined to first because there was no specific join criteria in our database. So I just joined by the record position. Have a look at this. Yeah, we can very well cross join the various databases. Can you join the file that have different structure from one another? You can very well union the file that have different structure from one another. You will not always get the file that are having the same structure. Okay. You will perform some of the operations where you can make the structure same for the two different files. But yeah, it is very much possible. Which file will be given the preference in the union operation? Okay, let us check that. And we have union tool with us. What we will do, we will union 1, 2, and 3. So these three are unionized. We are just auto configuring by name. Don't have a look at this point. But set a specific output order. So the answer to my question is the one you specify on the top. If I specify 2 on the top, my second file will be given the preference. What are the output from the join tools? I mean, that's very simple, and 90% of you will be able to answer this. But that comes in the certification sometime. What are the output from the join tool? L, X, J, and R. These are the 4 outputs from the join tools. No, X output is not present in our join tool. The next question is there any limitation of joining the tables in the join multiple tool?
No, there are no limitation of joining the table from the join multiple tool. Which tool can perform the VLOOKUP operation in Alteryx? You guys need to think of it, and you know, guys need to have a fair idea of working in join tools to answer this question. So the VLOOKUP operation is being performed by the find and replace tool. Okay, append tool just appends, select tool selects, filter will filter the data, but the find replace tool will find the data in the source file and will replace it in the target file. So the answer is B. What all operation the find replace tool can perform? This is again the tricky question. What all operation the find replace tool can perform, and have a look at the choices. So what we will do, we will drag the find replace tool. Okay. Find and replace. Now have a look at the configuration of this tool. Beginning of field, any part of the field, entire field. Okay. So you must be clear at this point only, that what all operation we can perform. Replace the starting of the string with the specified text. Replace whole string with column in the source data set. So yeah, A operation we can perform. B operation, you can perform, very well perform the B operation. Replace found text with value. And you will specify the name of the column over here. The third option is replace character from anywhere in the string. Yeah, you can replace the character from anywhere in the string. That is the default functionality of find replace tool. So the answer to this question will be all of the above. What is the difference between a cross step and a transpose tool? So I have explained this topic like 20 times during our videos. And why I am emphasizing on this topic, because this is the most confusing topic, and at the same time, this is the most interesting and most used and most asked question during the interviews. So as the name suggests, the cross-tab tool will convert your horizontal data into the vertical data. Yeah, me myself, just joke right now, it is not from the horizontal data to the vertical data, while it is vice versa. So what it will do, pivot the orientation of data in a table by moving the vertical data in on a horizontal axis. So what it wanna do, it wanna convert your tall data into a wider data. The second part, the transpose is trying to reduce your data from horizontal to a vertical axis. It will convert your wide data into a taller data. These both of the tools are used in parallel with each other. That's why they are asked a lot. The second question may arise, in what situation have you used the transpose and the cross step tool? The first question is, the first answer to that question may be like, I have yearly data in my rows, okay, but I want my file to be presented in a way that for each year I get a separate column. So I have used the cross-tab tool in that case. See, the cross-tab tool suggests one more thing, that it is cross-tabulating the structure. So it is just converting the vertical to horizontal data. Now, when you have used the transpose, a lot of time have occurred that, let's suppose you have 50 items in your inventory. You have the sales number for the items in the separate column, but for the reporting purpose, you cannot use those 50 column in your calculations. I have encountered a lot of scenarios where I cannot use those 50 columns in my calculation in Tableau. So what I will do, I will just pivot the data. I will just transform the data and I will make them into the rows and then use a single column. So this might be the use case of the transpose tool. Now, I just explained you what is the wide data and what is the tall data in the previous step only. Wide data is high, having the higher number of column. The tall data is having the higher number of rows. Always the best possible data for the reporting tools is the tall data. It doesn't support the wide data structure. It doesn't support the wide data structure in a way that it will improve, it will degrade your performance a lot if you are using 1,000 columns. Instead, it will increase the performance if you are using 1,000 rows. How can you use the transpose and cross-step tool to restructure the data and then move it to the original format? So many times, the thing is like that. Let's suppose you want to calculate the running total of your product, okay, under a product category. Let's suppose I have, let me explain you using an example. Let's suppose I have product category. My product category is food, P1, P2, and P3. My product category is food, furniture, and third category, let's suppose we have ornaments. Now for one, we have sales of 100. For two, we have sales of 200. For three, we have sales of 300. And let's suppose we don't have P1, P2, P3. We have till P1000. Let's suppose we have 1,000 product in all three of category and we are having different sales. Now the scenario is you have to calculate the total for all of the product in our category. Now you are imagining the pain in your brain when you will be doing this P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4 plus till P1000. You imagine how much it will be pain in your head. Okay. And let's suppose 200 columns, then again added up. What will you do? So the scenario is you will have to first transpose them make them into the rows P1, P2, P3. And what transpose will do if 200 columns are also added over here? Let's suppose we have reached till P1000 and 200 column will also added over here. It will auto accommodate this 200 column. Then what we'll do? We will do the total. Okay. 100, 200, 300, 400, and so on. Till 1000, we will get 1 lakh. Somewhere around this. Okay. Now again, you can cross it. What it will do, it will first transpose, then create a running total column, and in that running total column at the last item of a category, we will get the sum and then we will again cross tab. What will happen? It will just add the additional column. So this is the use case, how we use transpose and cross tab in parallel with each other. I hope I'm clear. What is the use of count record tool? Calculate the record of the number of records by using the summarize tool. But there is one catch. When we use the summarize tool, if there are no records, if there are no records for the category, then it will not return anything. It will basically return null. But when you are using the count records, you will get zero. For a category, if there is no record, you will get zero for a category so that you can use it in your calculation. That is the only difference between the summarize and the count record tool. What is running total tool? Can't you do the same using the summarize tool? Here you can see there is running total. Calculate a cumulative sum per record in our data stream. Okay, can't you use the summarize tool to do the same operation?
Yes, you can very well do it, but there is no direct way. See, there is no direct way to do the spend, like to do the running sum of spend. If you go to the numeric function, you cannot find the running sum. What you have to do, then you will have to do sum of spend first and then append it by using the append tool. Okay, you can create. I'll show you. You can create numeric and sum. Okay, what it will do, it will create the sum at the very end, and if you group by customer ID, it will create the running sum, but the other column will be missed. You will have to add other column again and again. But in the case of this running total tool, you can do the multiple running total at very once. You will get the original columns and you will also get the new columns. Which tool are the part of the transform tools? Select tool? No, we don't have select tool under the transform tool. We have select tool under the preparation tool. The second option is pivot tool. We don't have pivot tool even as an option. There is no pivot tool in Alteryx. Yeah, cross step tool is there. Cross step tool is the part of transform tools. The transpose tool is the part of transpose tool. So the correct option is C and D. How many column will be in output of the count record tool? How many column will be in the output of the count record tool? Let us have a look at it. There will always be only one record outputted from the count record tool, that is the count of rows. Even this tool doesn't require any configuration. This is a macro developed by Alteryx. I'll explain you what is a macro later during the videos, but this is a macro which is developed. It just count the number of records. So the answer is A. Which all operation can you perform in the summarize tool? So obviously you can perform group by. You can perform running total. No, you cannot perform the running total in the summarize tool. I kept it deliberately. If you have a look at the summarize tool over here, have a look at the spend. Can you perform a running total? I cannot see any option that is running total over here. There is a workaround to do the running total, but there is no direct operation. You cannot use you cannot create the running total by just using the summarize. B is not the answer. C, average, yes, you can do. D, count of null, you can do for the string option. So the answer to this question is A, C, D. Are transpose and cross step vice versa of each other? Yes, they are vice versa of each other. I told you in the very starting of the transform section video. Which all tool can perform the transform operation with grouping? Can perform the transform operation. We are not talking about transpose. We are talking about transform operations with grouping. Can it be done using the arrange tool? Let us have a look at this. We will drag the arrange tool over here. Is there any grouping option over here? Yeah, there is grouping option. Key field is not just group. The name is not group, but it is the grouping field. So yeah, arrange has it, the cross step. Let us have a look at the cross step tool. The cross tab tool does. Just let the configuration loaded. I'll explain you whatever is in the group column field is basically treated as the grouping. Group data by these values. Okay. Whatever field you will select in this will be the part of grouping. Now let us move to the other option, summarize. Yes, you can perform the summarize operations. Running totals, okay. If you talk about the running total tool, yeah, you can use the grouping. You can create the running total for the groups.
have a look at here the configuration of this tool. You can group by customer ID, city, etc., and you can create the running tutor. So the answer to this question will be all of them.
Your interviewer may ask that what are the macros and how they are different from the normal work. So if we talk about macros, they are the special type of workflows. They are the workflows. They have some specialty that they can be used within other workflows. They can be used within other workflows. Second, they can run in batches. The third one is they can run iteratively. And the fourth one is they are used for the location optimization. So we are having the four different type of macros. The standard macro, the second one is the batch macro, third one is iterative macro, and the fourth one is location optimizer. How they are different from normal workflow? So in the normal workflow, you can only execute them once. You cannot repetitively execute them. I mean, you can execute repetitively, but at a different instance of time. But this macro, you can run it iteratively at a single instant of time. Secondly, they can perform the more complex task. Macro can perform the more complex task, okay? In what case you will use a macro? We will have to use a macro where we have to implement a complex functionality and we cannot incorporate it into the current workflow. So, let's suppose we are working on any functionality which we can't incorporate inside our workflow. Let's suppose we are working on the data that is having the sales, and we want to find which if the sales are greater than if the sales is greater than 10,000, then if it is greater than 10,000, then interest should be something like this. This can be used for let's suppose each and every workflow. This can be used within each and every workflow, but this cannot be built in a single workflow if you have to do the same operation for the different files. If you have to do the same operation for 10 files, you have to find the sales. If the sales is greater than 10,000, you have to apply the discount of 10%. So in that case, you will use a macro. Or the second case might be when you want to run the batches. Okay, let's suppose I want to execute the state-wise operations. I want to execute the state-wise operation. The New York is being executed first, the California executed secondly, Oklahoma is executed on third. So likewise, you want to execute the different stages data, different states data in the different batches. Then in that case, you should use the macro. Okay. Iterative macro, batch macro. Let's suppose you want to find you want to execute a workflow till the time the data is not being zero. Okay, let's suppose assume this. So what you can do, you can use the interface tool in that case, iterative macro in that case, and you can make use of it. Okay. What is the interface designer and what does it do? So interface designer is the GUI of the interface tool. So if you are working on the analytical app, you have to have the interface designer open in your system. There are multiple areas inside it. There is a layout designer, there is a test designer, there is a debugger, there is a simulator. You can create the like hierarchy structure kind of thing over there. You can set the analytical app properties, something like this. So what's happening in that case is you can use the interface designer. So what does it does? Now let us have a look at the interface designer, okay? And we will have a look at what does this interface designer do. The very first operation that an interface designer help us to perform is, first of all, let's change to the analytical app. And then it helps us to design a layout. It helps us to keep the different element inside each other. Like if there are four elements inside this analytical app, it will help us to arrange this element in a better way. Okay. The first operation is this.
The second is it is helping us to get the test configuration. Let's suppose you don't want to execute your analytical app at once. Okay, you want to you want to run for a specific use case. You can execute that in your test environment. Okay. Now the test view is there. The tree view is there. It is telling you what all actions and what all functions are there. And the fourth one is helping us setting the analytical app properties. Okay. It is helping us setting the analytical app properties.
Can you take the field name as input on the interface tool? This is a tricky question. Can you take the field name as input in the interface tool? Yeah, we can obviously take the field name as input in the interface tool, but depending upon the tool type, we cannot take the field name in each and every input interface tool. So let us talk about the interface tool a little more. Where are the interface tool? Here are they. So let me drag the drop down the list box and the numeric up down, let's suppose. Okay, I dragged all three of them. Can you take the field name as input in the interface tool? Field name as input. So what I will say, yep, I can take the field name as input in only the drop down tool. Only the drop down tool. Okay,
you can select this option field from the connected tool and it will take the field name. Okay, it will take the field name. Any other tool will not take this kind of input. Okay, apart from the list box, any other tool will not take. So drop down and list box will take the input from the connected tool, the file and the field name from the connected tool, and this cannot take it. Okay, so yeah, we can take. The next is control parameter and what is action. How can you differentiate between them? So action is something that changes the property of a workflow. Action is something that changes the configuration of the workflow or the interface tools. Okay. And control parameter is used to control execute the workflow. It is used to control execute the workflow. We're gonna work on both of them and let's move to the interface designer and I'll explain you what's the difference in between them. So this is the control parameter. Have a look at this. Allow users to configure a batch macro control parameter. So a control parameter is specific to a batch macro, while action is applied to each and every tool inside the interface. Okay, let us open an example of the control parameter. So this control parameter tool tells a batch macro what values to use for each batch. Okay, what values to use for each batch. Let me explain you one thing also. What is a batch macro? Okay. We are having a macro that is a batch macro. Let's learn about this. This workflow is a batch macro. When running this workflow, it will run the tools as a standard workflow to see how it behaves as a batch macro. Open a new workflow and insert, right click, insert macro, this macro, use the master store in the sample interface and select the region column in the macros configuration. So this is a batch macro. Okay, you will be able to see that it is running as a standard workflow only. Okay, you will not be able to differentiate whether this is working as a batch macro or not. But have a look at the configuration of this. The control parameter is used to specify what value the macro should use for each batch it processes. Configure the tool by adding a label for the control parameter. When using in a workflow, the macro will show a question asking the end user select the requirement column to be used. So let's suppose we have this much of data: address, city, state, zip, lat, long, and this much of data. What we want to do, we want to check we want to check whether the region is north or south or east or west. We want to check on the regions, okay? And we want to sort by the sales descending, and we want to create a record ID, and something like this will be generated. So let's suppose, I'll show you. If our region is north, we want to sort our data by decreasing order of the sales, okay? And then we want to output it. Now have a look at this. Select the control parameter. This is control parameter. Now what is happening? When you give this control parameter, we will execute the workflow in the batches. Means this control parameter is defining the batches, okay? Right now we gave the region column as batch, okay? We are saying that for each region, update value default, okay? For each region, just filter out this. So what it will do, for when the region will be there in our input and the region is not, it will do this for north. When the region is south, it will do this for south. This control parameter is simply updating the value, okay? It's simply updating the value. Okay, so that's all, and I will enter, I will use this control parameter, use this macro inside a new workflow. Just give me 1 minute. It is saying that use the master store file cu.dxyb, okay, yxdb, use the inout. I would say use the open recent. What I'm doing, I have to connect to the recent workflows, recent data sources, and I will just see if I have this database that is mentioned over here or not. Allow me just 2 seconds. If I can't find the data, then it's okay. We'll move ahead. So actually we can't find the data. We will work on the sample superstore, okay? This is also the same data set, okay? We will select the sheet that is equals to the sheet one that is orders, okay? And we'll click OK. We'll try to find out which all fields we have in this. And let's suppose we have a region or not. Please God, have the region. Yeah, we have region. So what we will do, we will insert a workflow, control right click, insert a macro, this control parameter macro, okay? So we inserted this control parameter macro. This control parameter macro must be mapped to a field. So we are saying boss, choose a field, select the region column. We are saying the region column is the region over here, okay? And I executed it. Control R. Let's see how the batch output, the batch macro gives the output. So what I did, I inserted the batch macro and executed it. Now you can see in the output that there were 9,994 iterations were run. This much of iterations were run, okay? So that's what the batch macro is. So we are not discussing on the batch macro. That was just an additional topic, okay?
So let us move to the next interview question. What are the various interface tools? So it's just the normal question that an interviewer might ask you, that what are the different interface tool to test your knowledge. So you can tell them in the order of importance. We have somewhere around 10 to 12 interface tool. The first one is the drop-down tool. The second is radio button. The third one is macro input, the macro output. The fourth one is macro output. The fifth one is the list box. The sixth one is action. Seventh one is control parameter. Okay, and you have many more over here. A map input, numeric up down is there. So you can just tell him some of the interface tool, not every. Can you enable and disable any of the interface tool? Yep, you can enable and disable any of the interface tool, but not directly. You will have to work with the layout tool in parallel. You will have to work with layout tools in parallel. I'll show you how you can hide and how you can create. Let's suppose we have three tools over here. You can see, guys, over here. Now in the interface designer, what if I see that this tool will only be executed if I have selected something. Okay. Allow me just 2 seconds and I will have to find out why it is not taking this. Yeah, so I forgot to tell you that there is something you can add or you cannot add, okay, inside one tool or another. So yeah, so you can input a list box inside a radio button. You can use a checkbox, okay, to move one dashboard, one interface tool inside another. Now execute this. Now let us try to execute this. You can see that the label, the radio button, okay. And if you check this, just allow me two seconds. I'll configure it for you guys. I'll make the use of. Where is my configuration pane? Okay, I'll configure each of them, radio button, yes or no. Okay, on the default value, I will select the drop down. I want some of the random values. Okay. I would say A, B, and C. Okay. Again, the list box, I would say the random values A, B, and C. Now, this will not give you error. Okay. We'll move to this, and this will not give you error what you are having first or not. Now you can see that when we select this radio button, then only this is enabled. Okay, when we are selecting on this radio button, then only this is enabled. You can have drop down also. You can like move inside a drop down the other tool. So yeah, you can hide tool. What are the different type of action available in the action tool? So the first one is update formula. We got update formula, update cells. Yep, we got update cells, update value with formula. Yep, we got it. But have a look at this. There are always the if and but. Let me create the action tool for these four tools. Okay, let me create our action tool for these four. And have a look at this. So for drop down, the action is update cell, update value with formula, update select with multi-select list box. Okay, this is the additional option. The second tool we are talking about, the list box. You can see that only four things are available: update value with formula, update cell is not available. Okay. Now talking about numeric up down. Here you will find update value, update trade area radius. So the fourth option is correct in this MCQ, that it depends upon the interface tool we have dragged, what option we get in the actions. Okay, what option we get in the action depend upon the tool that we have dragged. So the answer is D. What are the different interface tool available? We have the list box. We don't have action box. You cannot have an action box. We just have action. The control parameter we are having and the radio button we are having. The answer to this question is again A, C, D. What are the different type of macros available to us? So I guess I have repeated this question again and again a lot of time because this is most asked in the interview. So we have location optimizer, we have batch, we have iterative. So the answer is all of above, the D. We have four type of macro. Even one is missing over here, the standard macro. What if we have added the analytical app over here? Then the answer would be analytical app is not a macro, it's an app. What are the various layout in the Altix interface designer? So we have debug window, update sample window is not there. Layout window, okay. So we will have the output as A and C. What are the maximum number of places that we can use a macro? We can use the macro any number of times. There are not the maximum number of places. Is it true that a macro increases the time, the running time? Is it true the macro increases the workflow runtime? No, it is not true that a macro increases the workflow runtime. It is even lesser if we use the macros because we have certain set of operation standardized and we always create a macro to optimize the workflow, never to increase the performance time. Now, the answer to this is D, any number of time.